to those ineffable joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God in glory everlasting.
Amen.
Reading from the book of Ecclesiasticus. Let us now sing the praises of famous men, our ancestors in their generations. The Lord apportioned to them great glory, his majesty from the beginning. There were those who ruled in their kingdoms and made a name for themselves by their valor. Those who gave counsel because they were intelligent. Those who spoke in prophetic oracles. Those who led the people by their counsels and by their knowledge of the people's law. They were wise in their words of instruction. Those who composed musical tunes or put verses in writing. Rich men endowed with resources, living peacefully in their homes. All these were honored in their generations and were the pride of their times. Some of them have left behind a name, so that others declare their praise. But of others there is no memory. They have perished as though they had never existed. They have become as though they had never been born, they and their children after them. But these also were godly men whose righteous deeds have not been forgotten. Their offspring will continue forever, and their glory will be never blotted out. Their bodies are buried in peace, but their name lives on generation after generation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count,
from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple, and the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them nor any scorching heat, for the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Feast days of the church, and we've been celebrating this day for 1,700 years in various parts of the world. It's a day where we remember all the saints, the ones we know and the ones we don't know. And then tomorrow, many churches will celebrate All Souls Day for all the faithful departed. Now the question is who are all these saints? Well, the lessons today give us a great variety of saints that are available. The first lesson from the Apocrypha, from Ecclesiastes, talks about those men and women who made names for themselves. They were authors or writers. They sang songs or published books or works. They were powerful people who had money and effort and ability to guide and govern. They made a name for themselves, and memorials are set up. And if we think through the church, we have a variety of people like that who are those kind of saints. But I like the last half of today's reading. There were also those who lived and died as though they never lived before. Think about that. Those who lived and died as though they never lived before. But they will go down as being faithful. They will go down and have been remembered, not by men and women, not by generations because they wrote something, but by the Lord God Almighty because they were faithful and true. And it reminds me of this hymn that I sang when I was a little boy in the church. I sing a song of the saints of God, patient and brave and true, who toiled and fought and lived and died for the Lord they loved and knew. Saints, where can you find them? Look around. The song continues in the next verse. You can find them in schools or in planes or in shops or at tea and various other places. Paul, writing to the Hebrews, turns around and says, we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses that we all need to step forward. On All Saints Day, it's a great day for us to remember the saints who have influenced us individually, the saints who have gone before us to bring us to this place. Because being a Christian is not about something we do on our own. It's about something that has been done in a congregation, in the church, and under the Lord Jesus Christ. It's about being a Christian in mission. One of the things we need to think about is who influenced you, who brought you to the place where you call yourself a Christian. Paul, writing to Timothy, turned around and said, Timothy, keep the faith that is already in you, that you learned from your grandmother and your mother, and now it lives in you, so that you need to stay faithful. You need to step out and do the things that you have been called to do. That's the message for all of us on All Saints Day. It's the message for all of us every day of the year if we call ourselves Christians. It's to step out having the faith that has been given us by those around us. In the gospel reading that was just read, we get a long list of the blessings. Many people like to turn around and say, this is what those mean. But the one that I want you to focus on is the last one. Blessed are you when men revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Doesn't sound like a good job to me. Doesn't sound like being a saint is a fun job. But if you think about it, the church has been fighting persecution since Jesus said that in the Sermon on the Mount. Christians have been fighting against the world and the devil forever. Forever since we've been the church. And so being a Christian is not about an easy job. St. Monica, St. Augustine's mother, turned around and said, I don't care where you bury my body, just remember me in the church. for being faithful. One of the things we need to do, as I said, is to remember those who have come before us. Because in this day and age, and in every generation, the church has been under attack. In the last couple of months of this year, which has already been a strange year to begin with, we've all talked about and heard in the media and everything else about people being persecuted. Do you know what the number one group of people being persecuted globally is? Christians. More Christians are dying every day because of their Christianity. So when Jesus tells us to deal with that, to be ready for that, we should not be surprised that being a Christian is not an easy thing. Proclaiming Jesus Christ is not what everybody wants to hear. One of the latest surveys of the American people is that for the first time, being a Christian is less than 35% of the people claiming anymore. No affiliation, no understanding, and no belief ranks 2 points higher. That's a problem in our society. And so you and I as Christians who have been built and given that strength from other people, whether it be parents and grandparents, but I'll tell you it includes a whole variety of other people. I was raised in a Christian household. My mother was a saint. She dealt with things that I have no idea how she did it. My father died when I was young. But every Saints Day I remember a variety of people. People that have encouraged me, strengthened me, supported me, forgiven me, blessed me. Some of those are still alive. And I've become the person I am because of them. To be a faithful Christian, proclaiming Jesus Christ every day. Do I do it perfectly? Talk to the clergy, the answer is no. Talk to my wife, it's a definite no. But in that process, I get encouraged and strengthened every day by those around me. That's exactly what Jesus says when he says, "Blessed are you when men revile you and persecute you." He turns around and says, "Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For so men persecuted the prophets who were before you." Going back to that first reading, some people have great memorials. Some people have written things that people will remember. Statues have been put up. But the majority of those who call themselves Christian are those who will live and die as though they had never lived. Their names will not continue on. Their families will die off, and they will just be done. But if they have been faithful, if they have done what they have been called to do, to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ, then they will live forever in a closer relationship with the Lord, knowing that they have done and been good and faithful servants. So on this All Saints Day, I encourage you. I encourage you to look at the people in your life who have brought you to this place in your Christian faith. To give thanks to God for each and every one of them. To reflect on what it is that you and I still need to do in our walk. To be more faithful. To be in that place where when we die, what we hear is, "Well done, good and faithful servant."
Through the Paschal mystery, dear friends, we are buried with Christ. solemn promises and vows of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and all his works, and promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship in the breaking of bread and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
the Shorter House Seminary, Community First Village, Grace, the Gainesville State School, and Union Gospel Mission. We pray for the life of the unborn. We pray for all who in this transitory life are in sickness, remembering especially Marge, Mike, Lynn, Nash, Robert, Quinn, Sharon, those who are in sorrow, the Downs family, the Gencola family, the Votto family, the Wells family. We ask you to sustain all other needs, remembering the Hodges family, the Baxter-Hines family, Michelle, David, Amy, Jody, Ashley, and any others you care to name. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to you all mercy, all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled, remembering especially Peggy, Tony, Gary, Aureen, Joanna, Sue, and any others you care to name. And we pray that they may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty God, by your Holy Spirit, you have made us one with your saints in heaven and on earth. Grant that in our earthly pilgrimage we may always be supported by this fellowship of love and prayer, and know ourselves to be surrounded by their witness to your power and mercy. We ask this for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, or in deed, by what we have done and by what we have not done. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we will not labor again. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may
celebrating a birthday or an anniversary, please come forward for a blessing. Let us pray. Watch over your child, O Lord, as her days increase. Bless and guide her wherever she may be, keeping her unspotted from the world. Strengthen her when she stands. Comfort her if discouraged or sorrowful. Raise her up if she falls. And in her heart, may your peace, which passes all understanding, abide all the days of her life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Carl and Lisa Lepisker are celebrating 31 years of marriage. Let us pray. Father, we give you thanks for the marriage of Carl and Lisa. We ask that you would continue to give your Holy Spirit more and more into their hearts, binding them more closely to each other, that their life together may continue to be a reflection of the love between Christ and his church. All this we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Well, I want to say welcome and thank you to Father Atwood. Father Atwood is the canon of the ordinary, sort of the bishop's right-hand man. And we're grateful to him for the encouragement and the reminder that we are surrounded by saints, and we ourselves are called to be saints. And so we're grateful to him for being here. I've known Father Atwood since I was a little boy out at Camp Cruces. He's one of the many mentors who encouraged me to get to where I am, and that's exactly what he's asking us to think about today, about the people who've encouraged us and how we can be encouragers of others. So it's wonderful to have you here today, Father Atwood. After the service, if you want to stick around, we're going to have an update on things that are happening around the diocese. Father Atwood's going to let us know about some of the great things that are happening. News on this 11-year lawsuit that's dragged on and dragged on and dragged on that's almost over, and he can give us an update on that. And then just some of the highlights of how things are going around the diocese. That'll be over in the music building right after the service if you'd like to stay and hear, and we'll kind of have a Q&A, and there's an online, it'll be on online and in person as well. Tomorrow is All Souls Day. Father, I would reference that in the homily, so if you'd like for us to pray for any of your departed loved ones, scratch it down on the bulletin, send us an email, send me a text, however you want us to do it. But there's a service at 6 o'clock tomorrow night right here in the church where we remember all the faithful departed, and especially our departed loved ones, and we pray for them, especially on All Souls Day. We're happy to include any names that you give us. Please just get them to us one way or the other. Time to start thinking about Thanksgiving and then about Christmas. I know it's a little bit early, but Thanksgiving donations to Grace. So every year we feed, we, along with other churches, help feed hundreds of people, hundreds of families, Thanksgiving meals. This year we're going to do the same thing. Part of what we're asked to do is do pancake mix and canned fruit. So over the next several weeks, if you're coming, if you'll remember to bring some of that, or you can certainly make a donation towards that. But it's usually almost about 600 families that have, kind of their Thanksgiving Day meal through our efforts. And you all have been wonderful at that and generous at that. So over the next several weeks, if you'll kick in for that, that'd be wonderful. And then our efforts of Christmas is for children. I know it's November 1st, but we got to get ahead of it and get it to the kids. And so between the services, there'll be a table set up out there. Kim Cooley's going to be set up right out there, and you can adopt a kid or a family or however many you'd like, and she can tell you more about it out there. The last thing I would say is today is Stewardship Sunday. You should have been getting mailings from us, different things. There was a pledge card that was sent out in the mail this week. When you come forward for communion, there's a little basket right here, and you can drop that in the basket, or I see some of you have already put it in the pledge plate back there. Either way is good. If you need more time to pray about and think about what you can do, by all means, take all of the time that you need. There are extra pledge cards in the narthex, so if you forgot yours at home, no big deal. You can drop it that way. Hope it's a wonderful feast of All Saints for all of you. Offer to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving, make good your vows to the Most High.
Thank you. Thank you.
supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me."
Let me never be separated from thee. Let me live and die in thy love. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus, dwell in thy servant in the fullness of thy strength, in the perfection of thy ways, and in the holiness of thy spirit, and rule over every hostile power in the might of thy spirit, and to the